dark and moody tone images have started to make a comeback on Instagram and on TikTok. And rather than just applying a LUT and calling it a day, here's how you can do it without a LUT on the color page so that you have complete control over how the image looks like. And the best thing is, it's very simple to do. Here's how. So I have a clip here of a tram entering a tram stop. So let's use the first node to do the primary corrections. So this is just fixing the white balance, your exposure and your contrast. The contrast could be a little more, so I'm just going to bring down my lift, bring down my gamma, and make sure my top end is not clipping. So I'm just going to bring it down. So once your primary corrections are finished, create another node, Alt S, and then in this node, we are going to do three things. The first thing is to reduce the exposure by 1 to 2 stops. You can do that by bringing the numbers under the offset wheel way down. So I'm going to bring this to around, say, 6. And you can see that the exposure of the image has already started going down. The second thing I want to do in this image is go to the hue versus saturation panel and desaturate the entire image. So make it black and white. And the third thing to do is I want to increase the highlights just so that it's just under clipping. Let's use the gain to bring the whites up, just under clipping. I'm okay with certain parts of the image clipping. All I want is my main subject to not clip. After you've done that, create another parallel node for node 2. So Alt P to create a parallel node. So in this parallel node, node number 3, I'm going to isolate the subject, which in this case is the tram, so that I can work on it separately, and then I'll work on the background by itself. Now to isolate the subject, I'm going to use a magic mask, which is a studio only feature, but you don't necessarily need the magic mask. You can manually create a mask around the tram and then track it as well. So go to the magic mask, go into object mode and just select the tram. And let's track it forward and backwards. And now what I'm going to do is just unselect this, and I'm interested in bringing up the colors for the tram only. So let's go back to the hue versus saturation and let's start pushing up the colors for the tram. Push the saturation slider even more to make it stand out, and you can already see that the colors are starting to come through. Create another parallel node. And for this node, I'm going to send the mask that we created for the tram into this parallel node. So this parallel node, if I show you the key, it has exactly the same mask that was on this parallel node. But what we want to do is we want to work on the background. So I'm going to invert this mask. So whatever I do on node number 4 will affect everything other than the tram itself. So let's go back to the hue versus saturation. And now I'm interested in picking certain colors and just working with them. So maybe I want to play with the colors of the trees. So let's bring some life into that. So you can see that I can start targeting the colors that I'm interested in and bringing some life back. So let's see what happens. So that's one way to bring it. The other way you can do this is just take it the other way and you'll start introducing a totally different color. So you'll introduce the complementary color of the color that you've just chosen. So I kind of like this look, so I'm going to go with this. Let's also try to impact a few other colors, maybe the red tail lights, maybe. So some of these colors, I can just start pushing some life into the reds to bring some reds out. Other highlight of dark and moody images is a lot of blacks exist in that image. And the way to do that is by adding a lot of contrast and by adding vignettes around the image. I'm going to add another serial node after this parallel node structure. And in this serial node, so let's create a new gradient power window. And I'm going to decrease the exposure and make the sides very, very dark. Something like this. And maybe another one for the bottom. Add a serial node, increase the highlights and decrease the shadow areas to bring the focus back into the tram itself. Let's take a look at the original. So we've gone from here all the way to here, and many of the colors that we do not want have been suppressed. The beautiful thing about moody dark images is that these areas here that are quite messy and loud, and there's a lot of things going on, which is distracting us from the tram, we are able to remove the focus from that and start focusing on the tram solely. So that's the beautiful thing about these dark and moody images, that you can now compose it in a way that your focus goes to where you want the focus to go to. Now, one other thing we can do is to increase the sharpness for the tram. Remember that node number 3 here has a magic mask for the tram specifically. So I'm going to choose node 3. Go to the blur window and reduce the radius. So I'm just bringing it to 0.44. Just add a touch of sharpness. Basically, this is the template for how to create moody images. And there's another step that I like to do is to add 3 more serial nodes. And in the first serial node, let's do a color space transform. And I'm going to change the output gamma to Cineon film log. Now, once I've done that, you'll see that the image looks a bit washed out. And the reason I'm transforming the gamma to Cineon film log is because I now, in the next node, on node number 9, I want to apply a film LUT, the Rec. 709 Kodak LUT, and I really like how that LUT looks. Now, for this LUT to work, you need the input gamma to be a Cineon film log, because it converts from a Cineon film log to a gamma 2.4. So I'm just going to apply this. Now, these two steps are totally not necessary. I just like how the film looks. And then if you feel that the LUT is doing too much, come to the key panel and just reduce the gain. And then in the last node, I'm just going to add some film grain. And I like the 8mm grain, and just add the grain size. We've basically gone from an image that looks like this to a very dark and moody image that looks like this. So here's another clip, and this one's interesting because the subject of interest is a human. So we need to be careful about skin tones so that we don't make it look artificial. And there's a lot of color going on here. So let's ask ourselves, what colors do we want to emphasize? So I'm thinking we'll emphasize the blue in the guy's t-shirt. We'll also emphasize the yellows in the cabs and the oranges that's there in the traffic lights. So that's kind of the theme that I want to go with, and we'll make it again look very moody. So let's start again by the first node is just your primary balance. So let's make sure our balances are fine. Let's make sure nothing is clipping to begin with. So something like this. Let's create another node, Alt S. And in this node, I'm going to reduce the exposure by around the stop. I don't want to go too dark on this one, so somewhere over here. And also reduce the hue versus saturation, reduce all your saturation. And let's take the highlights and almost to a place where it's about a clip. Cool, this looks nice to me. So let's add another parallel node. And in this node, I'm gonna try it a different way this time. So last time I used the node itself to isolate the subject to begin with. I'm not gonna do that this time. With that parallel node selected, in the hue versus saturation panel, let's go and qualify this person's t-shirt. So it's this area that's the blue color. So I'm gonna bring up the colors for the blue. And when I do that, you'll notice that some parts of the blue are selected, but some are still gray. You want to fix that first by increasing the width of the selection. Be a bit more generous in what the qualifier does for you. Cool. And the other thing is, I also want to make sure that the person's skin tone is correctly selected. So qualify the skin tone. So this area over here, every time you have a person in frame, make sure that the skin tones are fine. So let's bring back saturation into the skin tone and just go a bit wider than what is normally required. Cool. We were here and we made it to look like this. Let's create a brand new node, another serial node. And in this node, I'm going to do a magic mask on the subject. So let's go to the magic mask. What I found is that the person mode for the magic mask actually doesn't work very well. So even when I'm trying to isolate a person, I am going to use the object mode. So let's create a magic mask that looks like this. So let's track. Cool, very nice. Let's remove the overlay. And now with the person selected, I want to make sure that person is more brighter. There's a lot more focus on that person. So I'm just gonna bring up the gammas on that person. And don't do it too much, else it'll look very artificial. Just do it just enough so that they stand out. And also I'm gonna increase the sharpness on this person just a tad, nothing too much. and create another serial node. And in this node, I'm going to do the opposite. So I want to select the background and I want to decrease the saturation. Remember when we, in node number three, when we increase the selective saturation, unfortunately the saturation increased on the background as well. So I'm trying to counter that saturation now. So in node number six, I'm going to send the same mask into node six and then swap the mask by clicking the invert mask icon here in the key panel. So now I've chosen everything other than the person themselves. Once I've done that, I want to decrease the saturation and I want to increase the contrast of the background. Go into the hue versus saturation and just decrease the saturation just a bit. And we said that we are interested in bringing out the orange colors. So let's just target the oranges and maybe bring some life back into the oranges. And the other thing you can do is go to the hue versus luminance panel, choose the oranges and just bring up the luminance. Just make it brighter or darker depending on how you want it. Now, the next thing I want to do is I want to create a power window on this person. And let's invert it and let's decrease the exposure outside. So make it a lot more darker. Something like this. So we've gone from that to this. And you can pretty much stop here. This is good in itself. I just want to add a couple more power windows. So maybe let's do a gradient. Nice. So we've taken the image that looks like this into an image that looks like this. And the next thing we can do is my last three steps, as I always do, is add three serial nodes. First node is your color space transform. Make the output Cineon film log. Node number nine, get me a Kodak LUT. And remember, you do not need these steps. This is just to make the film look come through. This has got nothing to do with the dark mode itself. And in node number 10, let's bring in some film grain. Nice. I might just go back into node number 5, which is the person mask, and just increase the saturation a bit more, just to make them stand out. But don't make it too much so that it looks weird. Yeah, something like that. Cool. So that's dark mode for on this second image. So we've basically gone from this to this. I've also previously done two more images, so I'll just quickly walk you through those two as well. So let's take a look at this image that I've gone through. I'll just walk you through what steps I've done. Let's remove all the nodes. So this is how the image started. Here's the first parallel node. I've reduced the exposure, I've desaturated it, and I've increased the gain. In the second node, I've introduced specific colors. So I've introduced the blues. I've also introduced the reds. And in the next node, I've added a power window to make the foreground a lot darker. And afterwards, another circular vignette to make the surroundings darker. And that's the theme of these black and white moody images, is the places of the image that you do not want to emphasize, just keep making it darker. And the places that you want to emphasize, saturate it and make it brighter. Now in node number 6, this is my color space transforms for my Cineon log. Node number 7 is my Kodak LUT. And node number 8 is my film grain. So that's how I've created this one. And one last example of this couple who are playing in front of the house. This is how the image looked like to start with, and this is how we made it look. So let's quickly go through the nodes. So in the first node, you make it black and white. In the hue and saturation panel, the exposure is down all the way to 6.5, and my gain is up to 1.21. In the next node, selective coloring. So I've just chosen the reds and the browns in the wooden areas as well as in the house, and I've increased the saturation of that side. Then in node number 4, there are two gradients that I've added to decrease the exposure on the left-hand side and at the bottom. In node number 5, I've used a contrast curve to make the whites whiter. Node number 6 is to increase the sharpness of the image. Node number 7 is your Cineon film log. Node number 8 is your Kodak LUT. And node number 9 is your film grain. That's my way of creating these dark and moody images. Now, none of this is going to work well if you did not color correct your image properly to begin with. And here's a video that explains 4 simple steps to color correct any video from any camera. Go and watch that next. And until next time, bye.